for a sausage. The flag of Korea is waving, as it has done throughout the games in all the sports. Nice smiles from the participants towards the spectators who will be cheering them, I'm sure, no matter which team they support. I think the Koreans are very fair people in the way they support all the nations here, not just their own. Obviously, they cheer more fervently for a Korean success, but they will be fair in their support of the Indonesians too. Traditional toss of the coin to decide which team plays which way to begin with. And Shin says, we'll stay where we are. Thank you very much. Time, but not until we've had the opportunity to see the players warming up. The umpire for this match, already aloft on his seat, is Kresing Tongtup from Thailand, and the service judge is Mohammad Hassan Hossein Zadeh from Iran. So Liliana Natsir, the player I was talking about a moment or two ago, has a great philosophy, and her partner alongside her at the net, Tontoi Ahmad. He's 27 years of age, his partner 29. The previous results, this is how they've fared, overcoming the Nepal pair of Schwester and Tamang, and also Chan and Sei of Hong Kong. And they defeated the three love and three love. Now the Shin Bakchol, you see here, 24 years of age, from Korea, a winner of the Asian Games in Guangzhou in the mixed doubles 4 years ago. His partner today, Chang Yena, she's 24, and was also successful in mixed doubles in Guangzhou, but that was in an event last year. Previous results there, overcoming Wong and Yong of Macau. They beat the Macau pairing 2-love, and they overcame the in the other victory the couple from Thailand at 2-1. So that was a much closer match. Badminton has long been a sport that the Korean public have adored, which is why we've had good crowds here all week. They love badminton, they love table tennis. Some of the indoor sports are more popular than some of the outdoor pursuits. But the Indonesians have a good record down the years. They've both figured prominently in successes around not only Asia, but literally the rest of the world. And our Thai official, Krasing Tongtup, says, let's go.
MLF, Santowi Ahmad, Liliana Anasia, Indonesia.
Kuwera in blue and Indonesia in green. The match is underway. First point Indonesia.
One love.
Coaches sit and scrutinise from the corners. There is the Korean coach. He is Park Tae-sang. Cleverly placed, but it's difficult coming straight at the nose end. So advantage Korea at 2-1 for the first time. Ah, fine shot. Excellent work there from Ahmad. Just inside the tram lines, 2-2. Serve changes on every point. Well, that was where the left-handed chin came to the fore. Engaged by what they're seeing in front of them. And as tight as we expected. Each Korean point is roared, as you would expect. For tat at the moment, and it is 5-5 for the uninitiated at the beginning of the game. And when a score is even, the serving right goes to the right side, and when the server score is odd, well, the server serves from the left. First to 21, of course. lovely shot. She knows when to applaud and when not to. The feature of that particular rally were the terrific smashes put in by Ahmad, but all of them were countered, but Indonesia did eventually get the point, and they deserved it, I felt, on that occasion. Beautifully angled. Angled by Natser. Chang, it's 7-7, and they really are matching one another's strides. Side. There will be a break at 11 points, whoever gets there first. Eight apiece. Chin drop serve. Supremely fit athlete to move around the court with alacrity. That was awkward coming in at the midriff. Once again, Korea sneak ahead. Just came at a very difficult angle for it. Look at that, that's so awkward to return. Chang on serve. It's long. And a drop of the head from Shin. Neither side able to get 2 points ahead, it would seem, at the moment. In. Of course, if we do get to a situation where it gets to 20-20, the match carries on, but 30 is the maximum. Into that attacking shot, and he appeals here. I think he feels that that is out, that the shuttlecock was over the white line. He's having a word with the umpire. Let's have a look at it. Yep, 10-10. And Ahmad comes over to have a word with Mr. Tong Tup. Please play on, he says. Not too happy about the decision, though, I don't think. Well, it's been riveting, and it is Indonesia who get to the 11-point mark first, and time to take a breather, time for the coaches to come over. There's not a great deal, I wouldn't have thought, to be said there particularly. How to gain an advantage, because they are so even, these two pairings. Shin Bek-chol, 24 only. First gold medal in the Asian Games in Guangzhou of 2010, and also won in the men's doubles in the BWF Super Series in Denmark a couple of years ago. He's taken Grand Prix in Taipei and Thailand, Germany, and here in his own country of Korea. So it is Indonesia who have a one-point advantage as we resume. Oh, brilliant. He's like a panther in those situations, Ahmad. He's got quite a leap on him. He's got some strapping to his right knee, but he doesn't appear to be affected. And for the first time in the match, one of the two sides has a two-point advantage, and it is Indonesia. To the joy of all around, 12-11. Out it is. The line judge says it's the wrong side of the white line, so Indonesia has that two-point advantage again, and they would feel aggrieved if they lost this first game after that very dubious line call a few minutes ago. They have to put that out of their minds, and that's here to serve. Point back, 12-13, and Korea now get the serve with Shin. And a change of shuttlecock. No problem there. Close quarters, and it was a bit too close for Natsir. We're back all square in this riveting encounter. No clear water between the two teams again. That's the very modern idiom thing, isn't it, to just touch hands and say, come on partner, let's go again. Indonesia sneak ahead for the umpteenth time already. Points can be won just like that, quickly. Right at the net without the shuttlecock going over near the back of the court. It does now. Came right out the middle of the racket in that and it's 15-13. Yeah, he enjoyed that. Ken Career hit back. They do have good fighting qualities, this couple. Shin Bik Chol and Chang Yana. Back to 15 apiece. Now, I will not use the phrase that nobody wants to win this match, because they both do, but neither of them is able to establish a stranglehold at all. She was on her knees at one stage there, Natsir, and ultimately is punished. So the Koreans on top throughout the majority of that rally, and they forge ahead for the first time at 16-15. Look at that, down on the haunches, both of them. They can still play though. Down, but certainly not out, Indonesia there. Fine point. Wrong-footed the opponent, I think Ahmed there. And made it count as we move towards that 21 mark at 16 apiece. Play taking place on the three courts at the moment. If you can only concentrate on the one, it amazes me sometimes that they are not distracted by events elsewhere. Look. Chinese Taipei in action over there against China, and also Hong Kong. They have a match going on. Also against a Taipei opponent. But this one is very much Korea and Indonesia, and it's 16 apiece. With Indonesia on serve. First to 21. But there has to be a two-point gap, and it's now 17-16. So having stolen the initiative a few minutes ago, Korea are now pegged back. But we've seen their capacity for a comeback before. Ahmed used the court brilliantly there. Chang Yana sort of slithered in her attempt to get the shuttlecock back. Clever angles, and she flung the racket at the shuttlecock, but couldn't guide it over the net. Almost went along the ground. Done. Super play from Shin Bik Chol. 18-17. Well, whichever way this one goes, one team is going to be unfortunate. It's
too difficult a height for Ahmed to handle.
Again, I've lost the count of the number of times Korea have come back in this match to square things up. Talk about going to the wire. Recovery shot. Oh, they were on the back foot for the majority of that rally, and then I think that Ahmad was just unsighted as it came back over the net towards him. And it's 19-18 Korea. What a scramble, though. What a return from Shin Baek-chol. And that's where it... Well, he actually hit him on the head. Vital point. It's a crucial time. And Korea on serve. Within 2 points of taking the first game. They are within one. 2018, Korea. If Shin can hold serve, they'll take the game. Ah, the fighting spirit of the Indonesians coming to the fore there. Ahmad, remember, has won a mixed doubles title alongside Liliana Natsu at the 2013 World Championships in Guangzhou, so do not discount them even though they're a point adrift. They have the serve with Ahmad. There you have it. There you have it. Korea at the vital moment come up with the point that enables them to take the first game against Indonesia. And that was a perfect piece of net play from the dominant factor. That's it. There's that excellent Korean player there, Shin Baek-chol, and they take the first game 21-19, thrillingly. Liliana there has had a glittering career. Her highlight being winning a silver medal in the mixed doubles alongside Nova Widlanto at the 2008 Olympic Games in Beijing. Well, they still smile even when they are vanquished. But there's a long way to go in this match yet. The court is being swept, as you can see in the background. The Indonesian coach is, I'm sure, just saying, just keep playing as you are doing, because both teams are playing at the ultimate. They're playing really well in this quarterfinal match. That's the third one on court, first of the day, that is listed as quarterfinal match three. Ahmad there says he likes eating and playing billiards. It's an unusual combination. And that's the nickname of Owl. Maybe he's a nightlife fellow as well. So career lead by a game.
Second game. The ball.
Second game starts with Korea serving.
First point goes to Indonesia, though, against the smash of Ahmad that does the damage. They now will have the serve. Well, this is the sort of match you want to go the distance, because it's extremely watchable. A racing start here, Indonesia. There was never more than 1 point in it throughout the first game, almost all the way from first to last, but suddenly Indonesia have a 3 point advantage in the second game. Korea need to find a way back into this game. It's running away from them at 4-love. Maybe just lost a bit of concentration, the excitement of having taken the first game so narrowly at 21-19. Their first point. Long from Ahmad. Ahmad was critical to that point. Super play at the net from Ahmad on both sides of the court, and he finished things off as well. A combination of finesse and power from Tontowi Ahmad. He really is a very fine exponent, the 27-year-old. Hitting back strongly, it's as though they were so cross at losing the first game that they've got the bit between their teeth now. Don't let that happen again. 6-1 they lead in the second game. In doubles, just like singles, it's the best of three. So at the moment, Indonesia are on course to make it one game apiece, but they've still got another 15 points to garner. I think that's one of them. 7-1. The crowd is stunned. It's such a different game to the first one that we witnessed. Point for Korea to celebrate. A This is very much Indonesia's game for the moment. It's all coming together. The combination is working to perfection. Change of shuttlecock. The lead is narrow to 3-8. The number of the scoring side is given first. That's why I say 3-8 and not 8-3. Well, they've picked up consecutive points, the Koreans here, for the first time in this game. Just a hint that they've got the capacity to come back again. Really sent him scuttling. Well, it was a backbreaker all the way through there for Shin. He was twisting, he was contorting, but he couldn't take the point. 9-4. About fine margins, and on that occasion Ahmed just got it wrong by about 2 inches. 5-9. Well, it's better than 1-8, was it? 2-8 certainly. Gap is reduced to 3. And it's Indonesia who have to rediscover the ascendancy that they were enjoying. A rare fault at the net from Ahmad. Never in control of the racket there. First point for some time for Indonesia. Remember, when we get to 11 points, there is a break of a minute or so. A word from the coaches, and it's Indonesia who are 1 point away from that moment. Play. 10-7 they lead. They've been on top right the way through this second game, and having lost the first, 21-19, Indonesia have control at 11-7 in the second game. But not total control. So when they were 8-2 ahead, they looked like steaming through. So the coach does have a few words to impart here. Particularly seems to be picking out Ahmad. He plays out of the Club Jarum in Indonesia, coached by Richard Menaki. And looking at Shin there, just checking his racket.
He's a member of the Gymshan City Hall Club. So, can the Koreans come back and take it by 2-0? Or will the Indonesians show their mettle once again? More points for Indonesia. More worries for the audience. The gap is 5. 9 points away from a deciding game. It's in. A little pat on the back for Natser from her partner. Cracking shot right down the middle, to use a golfing term, but it paid off for Shin. Tall and powerful, and eking out an important point there. Made his debut in Guangzhou in the Asian Games in 2010 for Korea. The winners of this match, remember, go into the semi-finals. Impossible to say which way it's going to go as Korea pick up consecutive points. Stretching, and Ahmad spills over outside the court, taking a real tumble here. It was the angle on the shot that caused the problem for him. He'd just been over, way over on his forehand, and had to go full stretch to try and get the shuttlecock back. An unsuccessful attempt from Ahmad. It invited the smash, and he didn't disappoint. Ahmad straight down the middle. 14-10. Indonesia still has that advantage of 4 points. The wrong side from Korea's perspective. And if Indonesia continue just to play as they are doing, just making sure they take the opportunities when they're presented to them, they'll do it. And we'll have a decider. By no means are they there yet, though. 11-15, Korea have the serve back. And it's going to be taken by Chang Yana. Well, that was a real test for Chang, because she's had knee surgery recently, and they really tested her out there. She had to go down on those knees. Look at this, it's a real strain for her. I'm not saying it was the knee problem that caused the issue, but she was always struggling in that rally. Indonesia edge ever closer to making it 1 game apiece. 17-11 they are in front, having lost the first game 21-19. And the Koreans need to show some resolve again.
They are really on the back foot, Korea, now. And the crowd, I think, sense that Indonesia are going to take this match further. Koreans seem to have lost just a little bit of heart. The court will be swept, and it just gives the players a breather. But three very crucial points to come. If Indonesia can take the next three, it will be one game apiece. If the Koreans can take the next 3 points, they'll feel they still have a chance of settling the match at 2-0. They had to perform at their very best in their last match to beat the Thai pairing of Jong Jit and Tarat Chanerjee. They ultimately beat them by 2-1. And they're on the threshold of a comeback again at 13-18. They do not lie down, do they? Consecutive points for Korea, thanks to Shin there, 14-18. The forehand was too good, there was no response, nobody there. Indonesia have the serve back, and they are 2 points away from squaring things up. Ah, right down at the feet. Chang in such an awkward place. Ahmad takes his team to within a point of squaring it. And the perspiration beads are showing on the forehead there of Chang Rena. And it's got to be something very special for Korea now if they're not to be beaten in this second game. Get a point from the service when it was the least expected, probably. And have a chance again at 15-20. Chang to serve. Just in. I think Ahmad thought it was going to go out. It's a gutsy performance from Korea. Oh, that's good enough. It was deft, and what a way to finish the game. A little lob across the net from Liliana Natsir. She knew exactly what she was doing there. That was clever. And it gives Indonesia the second game. So having lost the first, 21-19, they take the second, 21-16. And it goes to a deciding game, which will be well worth witnessing. The Indonesians are highly experienced. And in their last game, they overcame Hong Kong. Chan Alan Yun Lune and Se Ying Sweat by 2-0. And prior to that, they'd also had a 2-0 win against Nepal, against Bika Shrestha and Nangsal Tamang. Well, it means so much to her, this game of badminton. She's had got a world ranking of 4 in doubles. Time for reflection maybe for the Korean pairing. Trying to regain the form they showed in the first game when they had to scrap it every inch of the way to take it 21-19. The lead going backwards and forwards between the two sides of the net. Chang did take a silver medal in the Asian Championships in the mixed doubles in Gimcheon this year in Korea. They do clearly have to have some chemistry on the court. And we've come to the deciding game now between Indonesia and Korea. And the first point going to Indonesia, as it did in the previous two games. Of concentration, just caught out. Indonesia tore ahead in the second game for the first 4 points, and they've taken the first three of this decider. An inscrutable look on the face of the coach. A touch of deja vu about this one. Again, 4-love at the start. It's a poor beginning for the Koreans. Richard Menaki, the coach of Indonesia, very pleased with his combination. And the way this game is progressing. And Korea can't get a toehold in it. They really have taken it by the scruff of the neck at 5 points to nil, Indonesia. And the crowd are silenced for the moment. No, it's a curious game. The first game of this match was so close, it was just impossible to call, and the Koreans took it at the very end by 21-19. But since then, Indonesia have been dominant, but never more so than at this moment. 6-love. They're unstoppable, it would seem. 7 consecutive points. Sorry. 8 if you count the previous game. I couldn't quite hear what was being said there by umpire Tong Tup. So he had a quick word with the Koreans. They have a point. They've been clearly rattled, but they needed that. And how badly did they need it? 1-7 they will serve. Suddenly rediscovering the touch. And forget about those first 7 points. Just try and concentrate on getting the next 7. Shin Bok Chol leading from the front there. Inspired by the audience, maybe. At least giving Indonesia something to think about now. Just what they didn't need, straight into the net, 8-2. The players will stare one another out, look into the eyes. In or out, key call. Big, big call that, and it goes Korea's way. They have the serve again at 3-8. No complaint from the Indonesian couple that time, but there is a committee meeting going on. No coaching until 11 points allowed. And Indonesia get to 9. They're on their toes now. And somehow you didn't feel that Korea were going to emerge with the point from that rally. And Indonesia at 10-3 are looking particularly good. Down from a great height, but it came down just the wrong side of the line, and at the midpoint of the third and deciding game, it is Indonesia who lead 11-4. Well, there's not a lot that can be said to the Indonesian pairing, that's for sure. They have got a grip on this one. They lost the first game 19-21, took the second 21-16, and a 7 point clear in the third and final game. You have sets in badminton, you have games.
Part 1, 20 seconds. Thank you.
Bring it on, I think he says. It's the Koreans who had a talking to from the umpire midway through that game. It's the Koreans who need to regather their thoughts. See if they can find a way back into the match, which is slipping away from them.
11-4.
Always tough to lose at a quarter-final stage. Crucially, you feel Indonesia have the first point again now on the resumption. Just left themselves vulnerable to the smash there from Natsir. Serving his arm up. Just thrown too many points away, the Koreans, you feel. Made too many mistakes in this third game. Luckily, the atmosphere is getting to them a little bit. Sometimes it's harder when the fans are cheering for you.
They've dug one out there.
Good work at the net from Chang.
Every point cheered to the rafters, so long it's a Korean point. Put that one away without any problem.
The left-footed Chang.
And the left-handed Chang.
Ahmad was totally in control of the situation there, and Indonesia are now just 7 points away.
Super play at the net this time from Natsir. And Liliana has left her female opponent struggling on the deck. And remember, I've mentioned before, she's had knee surgery, Chang. And this is not going to help her cause. She really has been sprawling around on a couple of occasions. Looks in just a little bit of discomfort. She will continue. The match goes on with Indonesia edging ever closer a semi-final berth. And you just wonder now if the Koreans have lost it a little bit. They do appear to have let their heads go just a little bit. Disheartened at 5-16 down. Seven. 17-5. Now the Indonesians are renowned for their ability, their fighting spirit. Take something remarkable to prevent Indonesia winning this match, but at least Korea has a point and has the serve back at 6-17. Good for Korea. Fractionally out from Ahmad. But they still have a massive advantage. Another crucial mistake made there by Shin. And I think the crowd sense that the Koreans, without giving up, are losing heart. What a chance that was missed, and no wonder Liliana taps her forehead, as if to say, what on earth was I thinking about? She had the whole court virtually to go out there and fluffed her lines. Game still on, 8-18. She doesn't flop her lines this time, though, and atones for the earlier error. Closing in on victory. 1 point to go and Indonesia will be into the semi-final. Well, the Indonesians are outnumbered in the crowd, but there are a few who are prematurely celebrating.
But one more point will be good enough.
And it is 1 point saved. One elusive point, all Indonesia requires. And Indonesia take it. It was the 1 point that was tucked away there in the end by Natsa and Ahmad, and they will progress into the semi-finals. It was a good match, particularly in the first game, which the Koreans took 21-19. They rather lost their way early on in the second when they were trailing 4-love and 8-2. They hit back but lost it 16-21. But in the third and final and deciding game, 21-9 was the winning margin for Indonesia, who took a stranglehold early on. And Natsa has clinched the victory, which takes Indonesia into the semi-finals. 2-1. Defeat for Shin and Chang, disappointingly then, in a match that started so well for them. But well done to Ahmad and Natsa, who thoroughly entertained us in clinching success for Indonesia.
Service judge, 22 Japan, and the team of line judges are B.